This was expected a little bit of a few weeks ago, Gavin. There was talks at European level that it might open during July, soon after the EU reopening. But especially there was bilateral talks that would, you know, our administration in the White House is more pro-Irish than it has been for 60 years. So there was a sense we might get this over the line, but it was pushed back. We heard it was going to be September. So last night's news was expected. A little bit slower than we might have anticipated, but it's certainly coming down the tracks. It's on its way, or coming down the runway in this case.
But earlier this week, the US Centre for Disease Control issued their level 4 notice for Ireland, advising that travel here should be avoided.
Yeah, that's since the July, vaccinated Americans have been travelling into Ireland. Since July the 19th, they've been able to do so without self-isolating. Quite an interesting boost for the Irish hospitality industry. And although the numbers are small, their presence has been very, very welcome. What happened earlier this week puts Ireland up there with Libya, Syria, countries like that. Do not travel. That has implications for travel insurance. And it's certainly the demographic that comes to Ireland from America. First of all, they will tend to be the ones that are vaccinated. They tend to be of an age group that would take these things very seriously. So it is a blow to what has been opening up. And it's a real sense of one step forward, two steps back, as we're getting the news that we may be reopening in the other direction in September.
Long way to go here, isn't there?
A long way to go, and especially a long way to go for the airlines. This is really, you know, Aer Lingus have been losing money very, very heavily, disproportionately compared with other European airlines, considering the size of the airline. For instance, their losses would be half of Ryanair's, with about 1/14th of the size of the fleet. Now, we're back to the core North American routes of our childhood, Gavin. Chicago, Boston, New York, they've been running with, you know, passenger numbers of 20 or 25 in some cases. Aer Lingus were hoping to reopen Washington in August, and they were talking about getting San Francisco, really important, that West Coast route, back up and running before the end of the year, possibly October. Very important for the tech industry. Every single bit of news that closes down travel or the possibilities of these routes going back to profit, it means it's makes it less likely to happen, and certainly not the range of flights. We used to have 28 flights a day to North America in 2019, and the range of destinations, places like Seattle, Minneapolis, Orlando, that were direct from Dublin, getting back into that game makes it, it's going to be more difficult. Now, the real problem will be if Europe to America, North America opens quicker than Ireland to North America. And one of the complications of the last 2 weeks has been the differential between Schengen visa countries and the common travel area countries, Ireland and Britain. We seem to be categorised in a different way by certain health advisories.
Owen, thank you. That's Owen Corry, tourism and travel expert. Let's